Hello and welcome to our TechBits series covering video collaboration using Zoom. In this episode, I'm going to introduce you to the plans that are available in Zoom. We're going to walk through creating an account for you so that you can have an account, a free account, to be able to practice some of the techniques that we're going to talk about in other pieces. My goal really is to take you from a participant to someone who is comfortable doing hosting of meetings or participating as a co-host in a meeting as well. As you know, in the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, as we have tried to adhere to social distancing and caution given to us, that we begin to rely on video conferencing types of packages like Zoom. And so being able to participate with ward members or family members in a collaborative way is very easy. It becomes very easy with a product like Zoom. So let's talk about one of the things I want to get done here is we're going to talk about the various packages that Zoom offers. And we can go to Zoom, and it is Zoom. It's zoom.us. Zoom.us. Okay, so I go there, get a nice page where we're wanting to pay attention. And let me turn my spotlight on. Is we're going to go right here, the plans and pricing. This outlines for us the various options they have. Now this is an overwhelming page. There's a lot of options. What we're talking about really is basic, which is the free account, or whether you might need to go to something bigger. And the best way to determine that, you're going to scroll down to this full plan comparison, click on it, and you get the feel for information about both levels. Basic, which is the free, you can have 100 participants. There's one admin on the account, which is fine for a basic account. And it says that the meeting duration is 40 minutes. I had somebody yesterday tell me that they had a meeting end at 30. So I'm not sure what the discrepancy is on that. But really the main thing between these two is the amount of participants, the amount of admins that you're allowed, and the amount of time that a meeting can go for. So for a practice perspective, definitely a free basic is going to be, but basic might not fit for some of the things that you're looking to do in your calling. So consider that. Then what you're going to do is you're going to sign up for free. It's going to ask you for your birth information to verify that you are old enough to have an account. Right. And then I can't type it in. It's not going to matter. So I'm going to go back down to here because the scroller is not going to work very well for me right now. There we go. Okay, so then I'm going to continue. Then what it's going to do is it's going to ask me for my email address. I'm going to use this one. It may bark at this because I already have an account using that, so we'll see. Like sign up. This is a verification that you're human and not some automated process. And these can be kind of challenging. Don't worry about it. You'll get multiple shots, but you're going to pick. In this case, I'm picking any square that has bicycle pictures in it. Picture of a bicycle. That. And then sometimes it's going to ask for another one. Either I didn't get that first one right, or it's just double checking. I'm going to do that. Okay. And then I've got. And then there we go. Going to send me a verification or confirmation link to my email. You're going to go in there. You're going to click on that. It's going to help you finish out a setup for an account, and then you're good to go. That's it. For our first one, get your account on there. The next episode, we're going to talk about attending a meeting and some of the options as an attendee. Thanks. Take care.